Hi there, and welcome to another edition of a series of interviews on the Hygienic Design Strategy, in which I interview EH company members that have implemented Hygienic Design as a core element of their business development strategy. And with us today is Dr. Sven Fischer. He is Head of Corporate Research and Development at EH company member Krones. Nice to have you with us, Dr. Fischer.
Nice to have you. Thank you.
Now, when and how did you embark on this journey into Hygienic Design, and where are you now in that development process?
So 20 years ago, we started with aseptic, and there the requirements for Hygienic Design rose. We had a lot of in-room class teaching and a lot of discussions about what is needed for Hygienic Design, what is available, and how can we improve existing systems. So it's really already 20 years, more than 20 years, that we have been in good contact, and EHEDG is an important partner for us.
Now let's zoom in on a very important market for your company, the aseptic processing market. And your company supplies most of the biggest bottling companies in the world, and Hygienic Design plays a role in the development of your machinery. Can you tell us what that role exactly is, and what are you aiming for?
We constantly try to reduce the time for cleaning, sterilization, dismantling, changeover, and all that. And there, Hygienic Design comes into play, because it is very important to reduce the effort of cleaning, to reduce the effort of sterilization. And you could say now, after so many years, we are there, but this is really a constant improvement, and we are still wanting to reduce the cleaning and sterilization times of our equipment and the changeover times in general.
Let's focus on the technical aspects now, because after all, you are the head of corporate research and development. What trends have you seen in the past years? Where are you now? And can you illustrate that with an example from the area of aseptic processing?
There was the trend to really open everything up, to have access, to have transparency, to increase the cleanability in these areas. So that was one big trend, and is still valid. So wherever you have good access and you can see or what is happening there, this is less risky than an area which is almost enclosed but not fully, and you don't know what's going in there. So this is really one trend that is still valid. On the other hand, we have the really aseptic chambers, where we have the need to clean and sterilize completely, where every single area is also checked via microorganism count reduction tests or things like that. And this is an area which you, in fact, want to keep as small as possible. So these are the two different directions.
Now, Dr. Fischer, apart from optimizing the hygienic design of your equipment in order to improve food safety and food quality for your clients, what other benefits of this increased awareness for hygienic design, of your hygienic design strategy, have you been able to realize?
We have come down from, if you look at an aseptic system, we have come down from 4.5 hours of cleaning and sterilization to 2.5 hours or even 1.5 hours. And still, with increased hygienic design, we can tackle this and can reduce this further.
Can you share an example with us in technical terms that illustrates how you achieved those results for your clients?
We move, for example, the caustic tank very close to the machines, so that we don't need to pump a lot of water and wait till the whole system is heated up. So we have it very quickly, and we can, with a good heat exchanger, we have the right temperature right away. So this saves time, saves also energy, and saves water to flush. And if you look further, We try to simplify cleaning by getting rid of some additives or special chemicals that were needed before, and try to do it really with almost pure caustic.
Okay, but what new insights or developments enabled you to do that, to approach this in a pure caustic way?
On the one hand, we clean internally, so the CIP, and we clean externally, COP. This was not possible before, when we had foam cleaning agents that needed a cold surface, and the pipes and the system was hot at the same time. So when we used caustic for the outside as well, we could do things in parallel, and that saved a lot of time. And then you had we changed the sterilization from wet sterilization, where you afterwards have to remove the sterilant with water, this saves water, to dry sterilization. For dry sterilization, you need a dry machine, and the energy consuming thing is to dry out the machine with hot air. This is energy consuming, and it takes a long time. But again, here it's most apparent if you have nicely designed slanted surfaces. It takes you 5 minutes to dry away everything, and the critical areas, flat areas, plastic areas where droplets might sit on top, and the crevices, there you need up to 45 minutes to really dry out everything to have an effective sterilization afterwards. And this time we can attack with hygienic design.
Now, the million-dollar question, of course, is what are the benefits for your company of all these efforts? Does hygienic design help you to gain a competitive advantage?
Yes, of course. We can we tell our customers that when we shorten the cleaning cycles by hygienic design, we can increase the amount of, for example, bottles that are filled on that line. So the output is rising, and this gives us indeed a competitive edge. And it's directly and indirectly, it helps to get USPs.
Now let's have a peek into the future. There are new regulations in place that will probably drive the further adoption of hygienic design in the food industry. Of course, I'm referring to the new GFSI hygienic design benchmarking requirements document J1 and J2. What is your take on that?
So I think it is a good movement that everybody tries to homogenize the different requirements. So it is really simpler to come up with a solution that fits for more than one customer, for example, and that are somehow standardized requirements, because the possibility, we have plenty of possibilities to improve hygiene. The question is just, can we agree on a certain standard which is accepted and widely accepted and worldwide accepted, or do we need to do it individually for every customer? And that that is important, because doing it individually may be possible, but it's expensive and it doesn't make sense, not for the customer and also not for us. And so this is why I'm looking forward to this discussion and this homogenization. And we think that hygiene will become even more important here, and it will give a boost.
Dr. Sven Fischer, Head of Corporate Research and Development at EH Company member Krones, thank you very much for this interview.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Dear viewers, if your company adopts a hygienic design strategy as well, and if you have a story to share with us, please let us know by sending us an email to the email address down there. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.